don't. Objection, it can be tabled. Question number six, Clayton Mitchell.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is to the Minister of Transport and asks, does he stand by his statement that the recent oil spill was not a disaster for the Tauranga environment?
Honourable Simon.
Mr. Speaker, yes, of course the oil spill was incredibly unfortunate and must, and I think has been treated very seriously. But say it was a disaster, in my view, is going too far for Tauranga. Can I take this opportunity to acknowledge the very hard work of the many involved in the clean-up. It's been a laborious, painstaking job for which I'm sure the House wishes to thank them.
Supplementary question, Mr. Speaker.
Supplementary question, Clayton Mitchell.
With that answer in mind, how can he possibly say that 20 tonnes of oil and waste on our pristine Tauranga Harbour and on our beaches is not a disaster?
Honourable Simon Bridges.
Well, Mr. Speaker, of course I accept it's highly regrettable. No one in this House in New Zealand would wish that to happen. I think it's worth bearing in mind, though, we have a tiered response in New Zealand. This is tier two. That means it is able to be dealt with by the Bay of Plenty, in this case, Bay of Plenty Regional Council. There's, of course, tier three. And Tauranga, as the member well knows and as I well know, has had some experience of those tier three incidents, which I think in some cases are disasters.
Mr. Speaker.
Supplementary question, Clayton Mitchell.
Can he assure this House that not a single cent of taxpayer or ratepayer's money will be spent cleaning up this big oil company's mess?
The Honourable Simon Bridges.
Well, Mr. Speaker, there's still, I think, some time to elapse before we work all those things through. What we know is Mobil has accepted full responsibility for this. There is at the moment a clean-up going on. We're the majority of the way through that. But of course what's also happening and will continue to happen after the clean-up is an investigation where those sort of issues will be entirely worked through.
Supplementary question, Mr. Speaker.
Supplementary question, Clayton Mitchell.
Is the Minister aware of any reports showing that Mobil are considering abandoning their New Zealand operation and as a result have not been maintaining their infrastructure to safe levels?
The Honourable Simon Bridges.
Mr. Speaker, no.
To question, Mr.
Supplementary
Speaker.
Question, Clayton Mitchell.
What are the consequences, if any, are there for these fuel companies when they spill oil on our waters?
Mr. The Speaker. Honourable Simon Bridges.
I think we've seen very clearly the consequences from these things. The reputational damage from these sort of incidents around the world is probably first and foremost above anything else. But of course there's also a full spectrum of other civil and criminal penalties that can be applied.
Supplementary question, Mr. Speaker.
A supplementary question, Clayton Mitchell.
Can the public expect an action on essential improvements to the maintenance of Mobil's pipelines in our ports, given his comments that, quote, he could not ensure further spills in the future, and, quote, there needs to be some realism?
Honourable Simon Bridges.
Well, Mr. Speaker, I think we need to wait and see what the investigation and other potential actions are before we decide that.
Question number seven, Joanne Hayes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is...